What's up, you, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Kris KeyZ, and this is absolutely the best place for music creators, music producers, and my entrepreneurs. In today's video, I'm going to do a quick beat breakdown of one of the songs I produced that was recently released called Candy. The artist is from the Philippines. Her name is Lovi Poe. Be sure to look her out. She has several other songs that were just released. Co-produced by myself and Omen. It was recorded by J-Soundz. Just give everybody a shout out real quick. Saucy Audio on the mix and master, VIM Entertainment is the label. Jeff, just so many people involved on, you know, making good records today, guys. So I just wanted to not only give you a beat review, but also give you some pointers for any up and coming producers, writers, or people that are just looking to collab with other people. You know, some of the best records today are not done alone. You know, there's several people behind the scenes, either that's producers, writers, engineers, whoever it is. So if you're independent, don't feel like you have to go about this on your own. Find people in your community, support their music, and I promise you they will start to support you back in return. But what you came for, this beat review right here. So you heard the beginning of the music at the beginning of the video. So I just want to tell you kind of like my thought process of me, how I produced this record. So I did get vocals from a talented songwriter called Alus. Shout out to her and go listen to some of her stuff as well. But I heard it and I immediately thought 90s R&B. So with that, I thought basically two or three instruments, that being a rose, a nice bass line, and some type of guitar. And those are the three instruments that I first started with, all right? And I'm going to show you. So as you can probably hear in the record, the rose, that is the first song, instrument that I started with. So I think what I'm playing basically for you keyboard gurus out there, and I'm sorry if I don't get it exactly correct what I play. It's hard to be like, what did you play? I don't know. But I think it was like an A flat. I think it like an A flat, a G, flat 5 to a C minor 7. Hopefully that makes sense and help you guys out a little bit. But it was just a simple rose pattern, and then I added a I didn't want it like a slap bass, but I wanted the bass to kind of give you a groove, a summer groove, you know. And you can see, if I open up my MIDI, you can see that I actually muted some of the notes that I played. Because, guys, this whole time, I say this video, and I'll probably say it a few more times, less is more. You know, less is more. So you add those two together, the rose and the bass. That's what you get right here. So on the first half, it's just bass and rose. And on the second half of that, I wanted to kind of bring in one more element. And that's when I brought in the guitar. And the guitar that I have is, guys, less is more. This is only two notes. When you listen to the record, it might sound like, man, there's a lot going on in there. But it's really only two notes that I added. And I isolated for you. It's just, and I'm using, for anybody that wants to know, I'm using Omnisphere acoustic finger style. And I think if you play it regular, but if you kind of hit the keyboard kind of hard, it gives it that slide. So So that's all I did. I just hit the kind of gave it a little bit more velocity so it gets that slide effect. Let me see here. Add that. And then I found one more. I felt like I needed just a little bit of ear candy. So I found this one plugin called Ultra Analog. And there's an arpeggio. That's what it sounds like. You know, so obviously that's too much. So I just played it a little bit. You know. Kind of played it. Release. Play, release. Release. And that's just a little bit of ear candy to go on with the the guitar. So from the beginning, this is what you got with everything so far. Right at the end, obviously it needed some type of transition to go into the second half of that or the chorus. And I just added a string first. Just a little walk up. You hear that a lot in a lot of 90s R&B music. And then I added a harp. Just that's it. And I just, on the harp, I just put some, a regular stock delay and some reverb on it, you know, little sound toys reverb. And together, man, that's just my transition. Into the second half of the chorus. So I let that play. And then I have this one other little breakdown. I guess you can call this maybe the pre-chorus, where the chorus change a little bit. Coming out, 2, 3, 4. Just more sustained notes. I was thinking Chris Brown. Got my Teddy Riley on that one. Just added a bass line. And I added a synth pad at the on the bottom of that. And then I go back into, now we're into the second chorus. So another little pro trick is on your second choruses for my producers out there. Most of the time I see a lot of producers, they just copy and paste the first chorus to the second chorus. That's cool. And I did do that. You can see I just copied and paste. But you want to add just a little bit of difference in it. Some type of, it doesn't need to be a lot. It needs to be minimal, very minimalistic, if that makes sense. And I'll tell you what I did. All I did was added a simple pluck to go along with the rhythm, just the chord progression of the song. That's it. And I took out the guitar. So right now, all it's playing is the rolls, the bass, and that pluck. I bring in the harp and the strings, take the pluck out, and bring back the guitar. Still very minimal, and I added one more different piece to the second half of this to the chorus, and that was a lead. I added a synth, a little lead, mono lead to it. A lot of 90s R&B has that. Yeah, so I mean, you put all of that together, guys. It's very little. I'm showing you my stems. Exactly how I made this, and hopefully this just gives somebody some inspiration that's creating maybe some R&B or hip hop. It doesn't even matter, but you don't need 50 tracks and all your beats. You don't need crazy hi-hats. And guys, sometimes you just need little bitty stuff. And I'll tell you, I mean, it says it has 22, but guys, it's really not all of them. I'm missing 1 through 3. And you can see this is all bass. So really, I just stacked a lot of different basses together to get a certain sound that I was looking for. But overall, I have one bass melody, that's one sound. I have a rose, that's two sounds. I have a simple two notes on the guitar, so that's three sounds, three melodies. And I have a lead and string that's really doing very little. So five things total is all you will ever hear going on in this song at one time. All right, so moving on, the chorus plays. I mean, the verse again. And I have another breakdown. And the breakdown is just the same. I just added an extra layer of bass to it, a little bit more depth. Coming out to the chorus again. So I added this time on the last chorus. On the last chorus, you can see I added basically everything. I added my pluck, and I added my lead, and I have my guitar going in at the same time. So really, it's the same, almost the same thing on my first and second chorus, but just one more element, or adding all the elements. On the first two choruses, I kind of picked and choose what plays, what, maybe one plays on one on the first, maybe another one plays on the second, but on the third, I combine everything together. And if you have a good song, good melodies, everything should sound synced up. So on the end, I just added a sub bass in Trillion. Yeah, it just added a sub bass to, I wanted to feel like I was going almost halftime a little bit. I added the detune noise with that. And I think that's it. I mean, I took out the bass, this other bass on the bottom, and that's it, you know. So that's the whole beat breakdown, at least the melodic side, and that's the part that I contributed to on this particular song. Once again, shout out to my guy Omen for killing it on the drums, Alus killing it on the lyrics, Lovi Poe killing it in the booth, J-Soundz, the whole team mixing, putting the whole videos together. But if you haven't, be sure to go check out Lovi Poe, the official music video, the Candy. I will leave a link in the description below. Until next time, guys, I see you guys at the tip top, not just the top. And you know what time it is. It's Keys time. Peace.